old and holding them in custody, often at gunpoint, forcing them to lie cuffed face down, as you see here on the ground, scared and humiliated. This was in a salon parking lot for upwards of 2 hours. That is hard to watch, even for a few seconds. Imagine living through it. That went on, as I mentioned, for upwards of 2 hours. This is America. This happens all the time. Most of the time, I'll be honest with you, it's not even on the national news. Now tonight, what's new is the woman you saw there, her name is Brittany Gilliam, is now suing Aurora, Colorado. She alleges in court that entire spectacle was an invalid and illegal arrest. She alleges the police were breaking the law. She also notes in her new suit that it hurt and traumatized those innocent children. You heard their cries. She says they now struggle with basic activities like eating and sleeping, and they are in therapy for this. The police department, to be clear, is not even claiming they had an accurate reason for the arrest and conduct you see there by the officers. Instead, they do apologize, and they say they incorrectly thought that that vehicle was stolen. It wasn't. An explanation that many law enforcement experts say does not even justify the force and guns drawn that you saw. Now, here's what else is new tonight. You may have heard that elections have consequences. So do social movements sometimes. The protests over the May killing of George Floyd led Colorado to reform police rules in June, passing a new law that bans some aggressive tactics and also a type of automatic legal immunity for officers, which means they can, when warranted, be held personally responsible in court. This is one of the first cases based on that new law. And while everyone's entitled to their day in court, this is the first time citizens in that state have actually been entitled to take on police officers directly and personally for their own day in court. It's very important, and we have some special guests on the story. We are joined now by the attorney for Miss Gilliam and her family. His name is David Lane. We're also joined by Mark Claxton, who's a retired NYPD detective, director of political affairs for the Black Law Enforcement Alliance. Good evening to both of you. David, it's hard. I just want to start with the human part. It's hard to even watch a little bit of that. You're representing someone who lived through it. Walk us through first the reality, and then we could talk about the law.
Well, Brittany was seriously traumatized because her four closest relatives were screaming for her to help, and she was completely helpless. She was trying to show the police her registration and her license plate number matched the registration. The police wouldn't look at a piece of paper to determine that this is not a stolen car. These kids had been for weeks and months seeing on the news every night white police officers killing African Americans for no reason whatsoever. And these little kids get pulled out of a car at gunpoint. And how any cop believes there is any justification for pointing a gun at a 6-year-old child, it's beyond me.